In this text ring jewelry CAD tutorial mini series number 3, I'm going to show you two things. First, design the color to cut out the text for this initial signet ring. Second, discuss the detail on making a mold for this ring. Let's get started. To design this ring, you kind of need to space out your text first. So on the top, this is about 15 by 5. And again, you can make it in any size, just need to make sure that you divide it first. And we're going to make this simple signet ring here. So that will fit into the top. The key is when we cut, we need to cut it, you know, outside of the form. So that will be a deep and bold cut there. That's starting from the scratch. Let's go to the front view, and I'm going to make a ring shank. It's about radius 8 or diameter for 16 millimeter. Depends on how high do you want it. I want to use the one is a line from the midpoint, and then I want to grid snip it on so I can snap it into the grid. And I want each side is 7.5 millimeter to make the total 15 millimeter. Okay, and then let's use the arc tool to decide how wide I like to have this ring. Alright, so this is a profile. We need to have this point to go into that endpoint. So we're gonna go to the curve. You have extended curve from the arc to the point. Alright, and make sure that your endpoints are on the O snap right here in the bottom. So we wanna go from the arc to the endpoint. Let's do one more time. We want to select this one, go from the arc to the endpoint. So now we have this. Let's go ahead to join it. And if we take a look on the perspective view, that you see that is right on the construction plan, right? So then the next one we wanted to do is we want to go solid, extrude it solid straight. Alright, so I do want to extrude it on the both side. That will keep symmetrical from the construction plane. And we need to have a 5 millimeter. That means I want to extrude 2.5 millimeter on each side. So that's how I get this one, right? So once we have this, I actually would like to draw a curve on the top. Just snapping into the corner to the corner, so I will have a curve there. Let me just creating another layer, and let's send that layer, the curve to that layer, and let's do it into the red color so it's easier for us to look at it. So now I have this curve. Let me turn the ring off first, and let's explore it, this one. The command we are going to use is called divided. So we can divide it, for example, this into the three sections. So that will give you the dot. The point is right, separated into three sections. We're going to do one more time here, and we're going to do the three sections as well. So now we can do is we can draw a line from here to here and draw a line from here to here. So that will allow us to separate them into three sections easier. All right, now it's the time for the design. I will suggest you to not to use any font. If you like to use a font, that's fine, but I find it's like more spontaneous design to make it special. So first one, I'm going to do the P, and then you can also change it later if you want to, but at this point I'm just gonna do whatever proportion it, I think it look nice. All right, so that is the P there. I may want to move it here a little bit, and maybe change that a little bit, but I'll leave it like that for now. The second one is going to be J. And again, you do want to design spontaneous for whatever it's going to look like. So in the J, I may need to have something coming in like this, and this is where that little opening right there. So that is where I'm going to cut out. On the other side, I could have do a box right there, roughly about right here. So I can cut off a little bit you know, the tail over there, and maybe it's too small. I do want it to be more pronounced, for example. And the C right here, I'm just gonna cut an opening somewhere right there, right? And then you can align all of this to look nicer, but for the demonstration, I just want to show you how to do it, right? So now we have all this text, all this line, and make sure they are on the same level for us to edit. We no longer need those points, so I'm gonna pick up those points and delete them. So now we have this, let's turn on the ring. All right, so we are going to create a cutter, but we want to know what is where the cutter is going cut into it. So let me draw a surface on the top view, cover entire things, and let's move this surface up a little bit and showing like how deep that we want to cut it into it, something like this. Okay, so after we have that, we actually got going to use that to find a curve. So let's go to the curve from the object, and then you have some things called intersection. All right, so we click on that intersection, I click this surface, and that creating a curve over there. So let me delete this surface, and then you can see that there's a curve here. It tells us that this is where all the cut is going to stop at this level. Okay, so let's take a look right here. All right, so now we can make a cut and to cut into it. The easiest one will be this one, and that's going to see the option that we have. If you go to solid and create extruded planar curve, and you want to go straight, and we want to go only one direction, so not the both side, and then you can snapping into here, right? So if you go ahead to bowling difference, then here difference is out, you'll get something like that, right? That is fine, but I will suggest you, for the production purpose, I will suggest you not to extrude it straight. Instead, I will ask you to try this way. Let's go, not going to the straight, we want to go to solid, extruded planar curve, and we want to go taper, right? So we want to select this curve, and then we want to taper angle. It doesn't have to be big, like 3 or 5 degrees is fine. And we want to go to here. All right. Then we want to do is bowling different, this and that. All right. The reason I would like to do this, if you intended to make the rubber mold out of this, this will be much easier for the mold to coming out without hurting the wax, right? So that's 3 to 5 degrees. Does give us a very good leeway to demold it, or your investment will be easier to coming out, or things like that. Just that little degree over there. Okay, so we're gonna do the same from the rest of it. But before we do that, we do need to coming back here to think about from the top view for all the rest of the color, right? If I cut it straight down at this position, that might be fine. This position that might be fine, but to be safe, I always like to have them coming out just a little bit, so that way you will make sure that you are cutting to outside of the foam. That's moving this coming out a little bit, and this one we need to make sure that this is coming out a lot, right? Because if you look at the front view, you're going to see this curve, it has a lot more right here, a lot more on the sides, kind of curve out a little bit. So if you don't have it coming out a lot, then you might have a little bit pieces stick over there. All right, so let's take a look on this one. I'm going to have this one and pick up that color, that curve for the color, extruded planar curve, and we want to taper as well. We want to taper to the same depth, and be really careful. Once you taper, you still have the piece hanging out from the outside, and this one too, we want it to be taper, and we want to taper down to here. All right, and be really careful that if you're gonna get a little gap there, since it's overlapping, so it's okay. So let's do a test. Bowling difference, this out of this one and this one, so we get that cut. All right, just want to be careful that you don't have that a little surface stick it out in right in the middle. So we're gonna do this the same thing. Let's pick up both of them. Let's go to the solid extruded planar curve taper down. So now we have this one. Okay, and then let's go to do bowling difference, this out of this and this. All right, so now we have things like this. We are ready to go. However, somewhere in the middle, it doesn't look, it still stick together if you take a look on a render view. So I do need to have a small cut right there as well. So let's go back to the ghost. We just need a small cut from there. So I'm going to draw a line roughly about this, equal distance on both sides of that edge, right? And then I'm going to make sure that it's a little bit longer so I can cut entire piece. And then let's go to the solid extruded planar curve taper, and we want to taper down. So let me make a copy from here to here. And then we want to use the gumbo alt key. You hit the alt key, then you can make a copy of it, right? So let's do bowling difference, this out of this and this, so we can have that cut there. So let's take a look on the render view. And if you see that is everything that fit into what you like, so we're gonna go with this. All right, to make it look a little bit nicer for the rendering and also more comfortable for wear, you probably want to give in a little bit bevel edge there. So let's do the chamfer edge. We want to do is going to the solid tool, then you have this chamfer, and 0.2 is fine. I just need to have a little bit chamfer so it will look nicer, and also all the outside edges here, also the outside on edges on the other side. So let's do the 0.2. all right, and of course inside we can do the fitted edges so it will look much nicer. Let's do 0.8 millimeter in the diameter, and then so you will have something round and comfortable to wear. All right, so that's the our mini series number 3 for the text ring. On top of what I offer now in my channel, I would like to expand my channel content to all 3D model printing subjects. I'm curious about what you like to know the most. For example, you can ask me how to be a freelance jewelry designer, the advice for the Rhino beginner, should I buy Rhino Gold or Metric Gold? Can Rhino do an organic shape? Should I go to the college for jewelry design, etc.? The more detail on the questions, the more accurate feedback I can give back. Please leave your question in the comments below. Let me know what you'd like to know about Rhino or the related subjects. I will collect all the information and may be able to do additional videos to answer all your curiosity. Thank you and see you next Monday.